पॉलोजेनिक इनहेरिटेंस और अनदर टर्म इज देयर क्वांटिटेटिव इनहेरिटेंस, क्वांटिटेटिव इनहेरिटेंस. दिस टर्म्स विल कमिंग एज ए साइनोनिम्स बट दिस इज नॉट प्रिंटेड इन द एग्जाम पेपर. सो इफ द जीनोटाइप ए ए बी बी फॉलोज पॉलीजेनिक इनहेरिटेंस दैट इज ओनली. So we know that quantitative inheritance also there. It is also known as a Blanding inheritance. Blanding inheritance. Okay. Now, since polygenic inheritance is also known as Blanding inheritance, so what will be the plant of height if dominant allele showing polygenic inheritance? So their solution will be AABB, it is showing 40 inch. Small is small b, small b, small b, it is showing 20 inch. Okay, so height of plant, if this follows, so AA capital B crosses with small b, okay. So this is 40, this is 20, and we know that in F1 generation they are having mixed inheritance. So 40 plus 20 by 2. So how much it will come? 30 inches. So what will the answer? And options are there. 20 inch, 40 inch, 30 inch, and fourth one is none. So what will be the answer? You understood that blending inheritance it is. So it will be 30 inches of their genotype if both dominant alleles follows. Okay, now come on next. Now, next question is there. How many phenotypes and genotypes is possible? Come on that question. How many genotypes and phenotypes is possible? Okay, how many genotypes and phenotypes if possible, if a character is controlled by four pairs. Okay, if a character is controlled by four pairs of polygenes. Okay. Now, options are there. One option is 81-9. One option is 981. One option is 327. And one option is none of these. Okay, now come on their solution. As we already discussed that in polygenic inheritance or polygenes, what are the number of phenotypes and what are the number of genotypes? So we know that number of phenotypes is equal to 2n plus 1. And number of genotype is equal to 3 to the power n, where n is number of polygenic pairs. So here what is that? 2n plus 1. So n is here 4. So 2 is to 4 plus 1. It will come 9. Then here 3 to the power n means 3 to the power 4. So 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. 3 3 is a 9. 9 3 is a 27. 23 is a 81. So here questions are asking first what? First, it is asking genotypes, and next phenotypes. So what is the first here? Genotypes and phenotypes. So first one will be 81 and next one will be 9. So 81 and 9, this one will be the answer. Understood that? So this is the polygenic inheritance. Okay. So one part of Mendelian classical genetics we completed. Now come on next part, that is chromosomal theory of inheritance, that given by Sutton and Boveri. So come on that. Chromosomal theory of inheritance. Okay. Now, this chromosomal theory of inheritance was independently proposed by scientists Sutton and Boveri. So, chromosomal theory of inheritance was proposed independently by scientist name is Sutton and Boveri. So this you have to remember, that who given chromosomal theory of inheritance. So that scientist name is Sutton and Boveri. Now this scientist found that Mendelian factors, okay, Mendelian factors and transmitted hereditary traits are almost same. Okay, Mendelian factors and transmitting hereditary traits or behavior of chromosomes are what? Behavior of chromosomes are same. So what he told? He told that genes and factors are same. Now, here one scientist is there, that name is Johansson. So Johansson replaced the term factor with gene. Mendel's used what? He used factor, but Johansson replaced that factor term. Okay, hereditary unit trait was there, that is known as factor by Mendel. Here it is known as gene and replaced by Johansson. So come on that. What are the postulates of this chromosomal theory of inheritance that we will see here? Now, this chromosomal theory of inheritance that also showing behavior of chromosomes. Okay, so Sutton and Boveri, what he noticed, that behavior of chromosome is parallel to the behavior of Mendelian factors. So Sutton and Boveri, found that behavior of chromosomes is parallel like factors of Mendel. Okay, what he found, Sutton and Boveri, that behavior of chromosomes is parallel to the Mendelian factors, or we can say parallel like factors of Mendelian behavior. Both we can say Mendelian behavior. Okay, and he given what? When in this he given a theory, postulate this in the form of theory, that is known as chromosomal theory of inheritance. So now we will see the salient features of chromosomal theory of inheritance. Come on, that what are the features are there? Salient features of chromosomal theory of inheritance. Okay, chromosomal theory of inheritance, what are the features are there? So first is, like the hereditary traits, chromosome also retain the number, structure and individuality. Okay, what I told, like the hereditary traits, like the hereditary traits, chromosomes, okay, what he first discussed, that like the hereditary traits. Now this hereditary traits discussed by what? Mendel. So like the hereditary traits by Mendel. Okay, so he, what he told, that like the hereditary traits, the chromosome number retains also. So chromosomes also retains the number, structure. Okay, chromosomes also retains number, structure, okay, and individuality throughout the life. And individuality throughout the life. Okay, whole life, like my hereditary traits were there, like chromosomes also written, okay, throughout the life of an organism and from generation to generation. Life of an organism and from generation to generation. Okay, this found that one? So that is Sutton and Bowery. Okay, who found that? Sutton and Bowery. And also he told that these never mix up and lost. Okay, these never mix up and lost and behave as what? Units. So these never mix up and lost. And what? These never mix up and lost and act as what? They behave as what? Units. And behave as units. Okay, so this Sutton and Bowery found. Okay, so this was first postulates of chromosomal theory of inheritance. Now second, what he find? So second found that both chromosomes as well as factors, or we can say genes, because it was replaced by Johansson. So both chromosome and genes occurs in pair. Come on, that second postulates. So both chromosomes and genes occurs in a pair. Okay, what mendelian factors also occur in pair, and chromosomes also in pair, occur in pairs. And where it is occurring? In somatic cells or diploid cells. So occur in pair in somatic cells or diploid cells. Okay, diploid cells or in somatic cells. Okay, now these two located at homologous site. Already we seen these two located at homologous site on homologous chromosome. So these are present, on homologous site, homologous sites on homologous chromosomes. Okay, so first what we seen that both are having the same characteristics simply. Okay, next what we seen, both are having in pair and present also in homologous site in homologous chromosome. Okay, now if we are discussing about a gamete, okay, so gamete containing what? A gamete contain only one chromosome of a type. A gamete contain only one chromosome of type, and what they are containing? Two alleles of a trait. Okay, that we will see in the next class. So till yet, thank you.